if the nurse hadn't understood my plight, you know, when she heard my intake story, when she was doing my interview on the telephone, I mean, she having been trained in what she does, she knew this man needs help urgently. Okay, he's depressed. He cannot wait any longer for 6 weeks or 8 weeks for his appointment to be set. He needs to be seen now. So she said, can you come to the hospital in 2 days' time? So, I mean, if I had been shy in trying to express my feelings to her, that would have been my fault. Who would have been disadvantaged? Myself. I didn't feel ashamed in sharing how I felt with her, because she was calling to help me. So it was my responsibility to make sure that I got that help. If I had shied away thinking, oh, why am I sharing this with her? I get very irritated, I get very agitated, I'm very restless, I have no sleep at all, I have no focus at all. What am I doing? Am I disgracing myself, sharing all of those things with somebody I don't even know? No, I was reaching out for help, so I was telling that person exactly what kind of help I needed. So, I feel that most of all, what we need to do is to overcome those barriers that hold us back. And secondly, to reach out. To reach out. Hospice care was provided to Humaira. Humaira left us in May of last year. I kept getting calls from those agencies in July, in August, asking me how I was doing, how the children were doing. Was there anything that I needed help with? You know, had I overcome my grief? So, the help was still there, even after. So that is amazing.